Frameshift drive charging. Fuel scooping. Fuel scooping complete. Fuel scoop disengaged.
Yeah, there we go. Okay. So this is one little system. Three terraform bubbles. And obviously that one we stopped to take some pictures of, pretty interesting. Nitrogen atmosphere makes it look really interesting. Kind of like bluish haze over the, I guess, more metallic, maybe oxidized surface.
Spaceship drive charging. Fuel scooping. Fuel scooping complete. Fuel scoop disengaged. Frameship drive charging.
That's kind of a boring system.
Fuel scooping. Fuel scooping complete. Fuel scoop disengaged. Frameship drive charging. Fuel scooping. Been here 100 times before. Playing the game, you need a changer. Closing a window, need an open door. And I don't like where I am.
A couple of pretty boring systems here. I know we're kind of getting out into like the zone where things start to get a little weird, but we start picking up and finding decent systems pretty soon here.
Fuel scooping complete. Fuel scoop disengaged. Frameship drive charging.
looks interesting. It definitely has an atmosphere. Almost looks like it has land. Water? The rest of these are just ice balls. 4K. $5 billion. Maybe terraform? I don't think it's Earth-like. I think it's just a high metal with like a... maybe a nitrogen atmosphere? Could be wrong. Still pretty new at guessing all these planet types and everything. Maybe we'll get a surprise, maybe it'll be Earth-like? I think that might be a little too close for K-Star though. Could be wrong about it. Try not to overshoot here. Sneaking a little closer just in case. Metal, but is it terraform? It is not. Looks like it's a little too cold, and nitrogen atmosphere, so surface pressure is also a little bit high. Other than that, it seems pretty reasonable. Temperature's maybe a tiny bit cold, but it still looks like a cool little planet. Okay, looks like it has polar caps, so... yeah. A little confusing to me. System map, not galaxy map. I think all these are, yeah, these are all just space rocks. Yeah. So, contour next. That looked really promising. I'm just not 100% sure what qualifies for a airflow mobile in this game. 200 Kelvin is like, oh, I forget exactly, but it's, say it's close to like minus 10 Fahrenheit, something like that. So I don't think that's too extreme temperature wise. These are some boring systems. Oh well. Trying to get somewhere. So. Getting in and out of these systems is fine with me.
Fuel skip disengaged. Frameshift drive charging.
That's probably a little too hot still.
Frameshift drive charging. Engage.
for those that don't know, just in case anyone's wondering, and if you're out exploring and you're still not 100% sure what you're getting into, in that in-between, you know, jumping screen, you can actually control where your throttle comes out on the other side. So if you're jumping into a system that you think might be a little scary, you can always either just like manually try to throttle down, or if you bind a key to zero throttle, you can just hit that when you're in jump, and it will it'll let you know, or it'll stop you running into anything when you jump in. So if you want to play it safe, you just zero throttle when you jump in. But I've jumped into very few systems that have been like a big problem. There's a couple really tight binaries that can catch you off guard if you're not paying attention when you jump in. For the most part, you don't like jump into the stars and explode. These neutrons are probably the trickiest. They're so tiny, their sphere of influence or whatever is going to knock you out of hyperspace, I think, super cruise. Like that, the diameter of that is so much larger than what you're used to thinking of compared to how big it is.
Fuel scooping.
More stars. So what are the other stars in this?
Fuel scooping complete.
Just M's. Yeah, these two are probably too far out. Still close enough that I'm running to other. Those aren't that far out. Tagging another two stars. Stars normally scan. Yeah. Like that guy didn't even try. Like stars normally scan from 2,000 to 5,000 light seconds away. So even if you're just kind of. You know, if you're under 5,000, it's worth at least seeing what that range is, if it'll start scanning sooner or... I think, like, the center of the... or the higher end of the, star classes... they're generally pretty massive, so you can scan them from further away. Yeah, it takes an extra couple seconds just to scan them, but might as well. We are trying to move, but this isn't, it's not a big deal to scan those, you know, compared to the relative value.
Scooping.
Probably another big star system. Eldorfs, huh. First discovered by no one, apparently. Maybe they just had their account cleaned or something.
Fuel Fuel scooping complete.
It's kind of weird, I don't think I've ever seen that. Where it's explored but it doesn't have a name attached to it. Kind of weird too, because I'm kind of in the higher planes, which I would normally think is kind of unexplored regions, but I guess that's not always true.
Friendship drive charging.
We're kind of traveling up the well, we were going to travel straight up the spiral arm and kind of sneak into the core, or maybe pick up some black holes and head back. But we kind of decided to take a more direct route towards the core because there's nebula that I kind of want to see. I'll just look for interesting things to lead me in that direction.
Fuel scooping.
Three. So apparently this chunk of space is just going to be a mess of stars that don't have a lot going on. They should all be reasonable. Not worth going out. These are all in the reasonable class of stars that you expect to have stuff going on with them. But I guess just this elevation isn't super conductive to a lot of planetary formation, which is a shame. I mean, it might make more sense to go back down eventually to a lower plane, but we're chasing after a B-class star? Gas giants, not bad. Maybe this one. One looks interesting, perhaps.
Fuel scooping complete.
It's pretty close too. That might just scan from where we are.
Fuel scoop disengaged.
Don't have to go too far away. So many moons. Oh, that's all the asteroid belt or whatever it is. Most of these will probably scan without too much running around, which is always nice. Just a regular Jovian. Metal Arch and an icy ring. Not bad. For sure, would it's better. Just have to keep kind of like refreshing. Or if you can just leave and figure out where something is. If that updates correctly. Probably have to do a little bit of traveling for this, but I think for the most part, gas giants are worth going after if they're, you know, approximately 3,000 light years. Because they have the same relative value as just kind of like mainline stars. So in general, I mean, they're outside of terraformables and Earth-likes, no special stellar objects, kind of your bread and butter. You can see the star density out where I'm at is pretty low too. Like, relatively speaking, we're still on a pretty, we're still pretty close to Sol, and it's not that dense here. Trying to cast across this little gap. See how it works out though. This guy's pretty small to, I guess 600-ish is medium mass, but like comparatively looks like a bit smaller. Oh wow, temperatures on these are really cold. Looks like all these were pretty boring gas giants, but I don't think any of them had nothing had life on it, so all pretty boring class ones.
Frameshift drive charging.
Objects. All this is already. What? Why would you? That's weird. Like this? Why is this undiscovered? Why are these undiscovered? Class A, but you missed the three probably like most valuable planets? That doesn't make sense to me. I would say the three of those are in the terraformable, possibly. But what looks like it could be a water world as well. Like this guy's probably just the high fuel content. Like just kind of blasted. But the others look like they might be far enough away to be reasonable. If they're, I guess you're too lazy to go to the 1,000 light seconds to pick up those planets, but I think that puts them in a pretty sweet spot. That might be too fast. That might be too fast. Try to wiggle a little bit here. Okay, yeah, we're good. Yeah, I think at that distance from a startup that big, that's kind of the sweet spot. I get scanning this is pretty easy. Surface temperatures are really high. With water atmosphere, wow. Like, how do you not scan this? I don't get that one. Like the outer planets, those outer two, I can see not scanning. They're pretty far out there, so they're probably just rock or ice. These three, like those are bread and butter. Maybe somebody else has scanned them too and just, you know, hasn't turned their stuff in, but. Ah, crap. No. Looks like we're taking the round trip here. We wanted to get close. Look at that. That's how do you not scan this world? Getting a little closer to this. But, okay, somebody literally just passed up an Earth-like. Why would you do that? Landmasses seem kind of spread apart. They're not huge. There's definitely some weather activities going on. See if we can get the cockpit out of view here. Good one just kind of centered on it. Another one that's more galaxy in the background. Alright. So yeah, that's currently are unnamed, discovered by so indigenous life suitable for water-based life, like full-on Earth-like. I think it's maybe a little bit on the warm side of things, but how do you just like pass that up? How were these not scanned and the other parts were? we'll see. I think those other, at least this one, should be terraformable. That third planet might be a tiny bit too far out. So. I mean, this one is, it's reasonably close. This is Earth-like, and it's still on the warm side, so this one, I would guess, would be terraformable. This one looks like it definitely has an atmosphere and water. Just kind of hard to tell. Probably look at this one too, but without kind of seeing what the globe looks like, it's hard to tell. It's probably just a rock, but there's a chance it could be like a thick atmosphere that makes it look uniform. It's pretty small. Picked up at 100 light seconds. Maybe it's not massive enough. Let's see. Oh, it's actually 2.5 Earth masses. Huh. The atmospheres. Temperature looks like it's maybe a little low, but you'd be surprised. This one's probably gonna be too cold. Yeah. The rest of them are pretty much just rocks. I'll check this guy out. It's a high metal, but might be interesting. Maybe an atmosphere that's decent.
Frameshift drive charging.
Yeah, that was a interesting system, especially the fact that it was the star in that first planet was scanned, but they completely ignored the world that looks like an Earth-like from the mini-map, or from the system map, and then gets 1,000 light seconds away, but that's not that far. So I don't know. I'll take it, I'll put my name on it. Happens to work out that way, but
fuel scooping.
That's a busy system. Four Jovians with a bunch of moons and some space junk. See, some of these are pretty interesting. A third gas giant makes me a little suspicious of if maybe it has a methane, or maybe it's like a methane that supports carbon life, something like that. I think gas giants like this I've seen life on pretty frequently. And the blue ones are just kind of bleh in general, but brown ones and the off-color ones, I tend to see a bit more as far as life. Water-based life. That's a good start that we already have one. That's, I think, gas giants with, you know, with a life form on them are pretty valuable too. Not like, you know, they're nothing like an Earth-like, as far as value goes, but definitely nice finds. We're at like 70, or whatever that is. 70 or 80. I'm gonna get that next giant right beside it. That's just a regular class 3. Based. Life. See, this one is probably worth passing up, but since we did find two other gas with life, scan this one just in case. Generally, I think the white and the blue gas giants normally don't have life on them. You know, kind of like the browner ones, mixed color ones are more likely, as far as what I've seen my handful of space traveling days. Kind of see them Pathfinder rank halfway, which is, relatively speaking, you know, it's just scratching the surface of getting towards elite. I can see I haven't done a whole lot of combat, and I've done a decent bit of trading, but nothing, nothing to write home about. This guy is massive enough that we don't have to go too far. Start picking up at like 900 light seconds, maybe. Can punch out of this system. Last exploration was out kind of in this sector, this area of space, and I found some really nice systems out there, some big systems, some found one Earth, like a couple of water, pneumonia, stuff like that, a handful of terraformables. Yeah, so that's just a regular old gas giant.
Frameshift drive charging.
I wonder if that's like a higher class star. Put this one at the 0XL when we jump in, just in case. Bright blue stuff like that is kind of scary to jump into. Are definitely cool looking. And this guy looks like he has an atmosphere, and probably just a regular high metal, an atmosphere, maybe nitrogen. Looks like cool stuff is going on there. Oh, like a little rock here sticking out too. He's real close. I think has to be like a molten ball. Metal rich. Oh, it has an atmosphere too. Metallic vapor. Surface temperature. It's pretty crazy. Kelvin is pretty toasty. Van Fabio. That's an interesting DJ name. Let's see what's closest to us. I think that whatever is behind it, or just to the right there, is kind of far out. Just a regular old class 4. See, anything special going on here? Nope, just a class 3. All these moves look pretty boring. So this is a planet I would consider skipping over, but it does have an atmosphere. The grand scheme of things, it's probably not worth checking out. Probably. So all these have been, you know, pretty boring and standard gas giants. Can see that surface temperature is already starting to drop off pretty quickly out here. I think that's, you know. Oh wow, I missed the star. Okay, missed scanning the star. But it is an A class, so. And it wouldn't be the craziest thing if this wasn't a completely frozen chunk of rock here. But I'm not expecting great things out of it. Okay, so it's just a regular high metal with nitrogen. Pretty cold too. It's a decent size. Yeah, we messed up not scanning this. Oh wow. Okay, class A. Again, from 6,000 light seconds, almost 7.
Frameshift drive charging.
See if these these two were relatively close. We'll scan those as well. So they've been picked up before. Yeah, it looks like they're pretty close.
Fuel scooping complete. Fuel scoop disengaged.
They orbiting him the moon with a satellite. I don't know how best to describe that. Always interesting when you see that. It looks like the next one's only 1,000 light seconds away. Might still be worth it since that one isn't discovered yet. That one just looks like a regular old rock, the ring on it.
Frameshift drive charging.
Got a crispy critter. Well, gas giants. And like this one, it's a lot of atmosphere going on there.
Fuel scooping. Fuel scoop disengaged.
So again, the off-color gas giants tend to be the ones with the life on them. These guys are all probably born old giants. Uh, 5,000 away. It's kind of like the outer limits of where I'd want to really look for stuff. Looks like it's a little closer. We'll probably just scan that and get out of here.
Frameshift drive charging.
Trying to figure out how far it kind of traveled. My thought was that guy was about 950 light years away when we first started. So, well, I guess maybe we haven't done the 200 or the like 800 light years. It's definitely not worth going out to the other, that other star. It's way too far away to be worth it.
Frameshift drive charging.
Unless there's some really interesting planets around it, just for a single star, you know. 10 light years is probably
Four,
pushing it.
3, 2, 1, engage.
No, like, data's fine. Because keep in mind, you're only really traveling like 5 of that until you can get a decent scan. Got a buddy over here. Yeah, he's probably not worth sticking around to see.
Fuel scooping.
Kind of buzz this one and pick up some juice on the way out. Two or 627 is the max for the scoop, so you can kind of tell that's optimal. Normally don't stay too close, don't stay at that max scoop range too long. But we're just doing a flyby, we're just kind of cruising off to your destination, and that's fine. Stay on that for probably like a good 10 seconds before anything really starts getting a little smoky and uncomfortable. I think that's the one thing. If I had to suggest, like normally everyone says, oh, if you're going exploring, just get like a D everything. Yeah, because D is the lightest across the all the parts. I think those are just both water worlds. That's just a high metal with atmosphere. I don't think that's Earth-like. Should be interesting. Yeah. Oh. That's why that wasn't picked up yet. Not properly start scanning it. But yeah, like, we're still relatively close.
Fuel scooping.
And we're probably. Yeah, I guess, I mean, we're still kind of under 1,000 light seconds away. You can probably get out here quicker if you wanted to. So, running into stuff that's been explored isn't too crazy. Though again, like, we are in the higher Z-axis, so not going to be as many people up here. Even though it's still relatively close to Seoul. But, yeah, somebody's gonna have that same idea. And it's not like Seoul's the definitive Z-axis to be on. Oops. That's too fast. Maybe catch it? We're gonna zing by. Yeah, we kind of salvaged that a little bit. A little bit of a salvage. See, it's a pretty bright star. Not like super massive or anything, but do just fine. I think it'll keep this airplane its in the warmer zone. Maybe just a little too hot for terraform rules, but 400 light seconds away. Might be alright. I think this one is the water. Yeah, that's just a regular old water world. I don't think there was anything. Oh, it is. Okay. Yeah. Terraforming water world. Looks like someone else got here first, but. Okay, so they're both terraforming water worlds. I wonder if the other one has anything going on ecologically. Probably not. Huh? That one does have interesting if they gave the the surface landmass. Those are both pretty small. paying attention. Terraform rewards. Yeah, that one's temperature wise, it's pretty close to terraformable. I guess it just maybe a little too burnt out. Stuff too. Surprised he scanned them there. Does that make sense? It's kind of right there. Doesn't take too much time, but I don't think it actually adds much, if any, value. To get to where we want to go. So we'll probably get to our destination, call it a night.
Frameship drive charging.
Oh. Hey, how's it going? Quentin? Better at looking at the chat, but okay. Maybe life on that one.
Fuel scooping. Fuel scoop disengaged.
I think at some point too, I'll make it a point to put the color matrix in the channel description. Like, I don't think it's that uncommon, but I like the more muted colors for exploring. Like the default orange is just, it's a little too much. Sometimes it looks a little funky, especially in docks. Text is just a little too blurry, but overall I like the kind of more muted purple. Oh in your life, yay. I should start picking up pretty soon. I see he's pretty small too. I don't think either of those had to. Range for a little bit of scooping here.
Fuel scooping.
Closer. There we go, 300's about even. So, 4 giants, 2 belts. Looks, that's pretty reasonable. Guessing at least one of the two has life on it. Your old ammonia-based radioplankton or whatnot. Hit this one up. Not sure if that's actually the closest. Yeah, I think the other one, I think one of those is. And maybe not. Those are just asteroid belts. Alright, yeah, it could be this guy. We'll just get this guy If this gas giant sits on the same side of the sun, the other two, we'll definitely make sure to get the other off-color gas giant. Let's see what the other one looks like. So we kind of, we kind of end up going the other way around, but I suspect this one is also a ammonia life. Back up to 70, I think that one's reasonable. Who left on that one? We got one of the two, that's not too bad. This one I expect to be pretty boring. Well, too much time in the map. Let's look at this guy. Kind of intimidating here this close, but big old blue ball. Of course, our targeted system is on the other side of the planet. Gonna take a little bit to get around, which is kind of the annoying part of getting in that close. And we're just so far into its gravitational well, it'd take us a bit to break away from it.
Charging.
Oh, the joys of cat ownership. Wrestle my cat out of a window sill to close a window. Not too happy with me. The other window is still open, but just not the window he wanted to be open. Bunch of suns in the system. Just ours. Yep. So, two binaries.
Fuel scooping complete.
So it's two binaries being rotated by two separate stars, so it's effectively two trinary systems rotating around each other. Always fun. Let's see if any of them are... Oh, ow. Okay, so these three are really close together. The other ones are too far away to be worth exploring, but... So, what, probably two dwarfs, and that might be a small M. And they all have fur fleet. Yeah, they're all the same age too. Makes sense. So. Yeah, that's just regular. Class M. So, fun little system. Not totally convinced that, you know, a system like that natural, but I don't think it's, you know, too out of
frameshift drive
too questionable as far as, you know, something like that existing. I think that many stars in the system is just kind of, it requires a lot of mass to put together, so maybe a little bit of a stretch from what we could expect. Like, anything over five stars in a system, just like a little bit of a stretch to me. But, you know, partially procedurally generated universe, you can't complain too much about how they pick everything. That's a boring system. I don't know if this is our last jump. It might. I have one or two jumps left. A little surface skimming here.
Fuel scooping complete.
Oh, yep, I think that's that might be your last jump. Just judging off of what that star looks like.
Friendship drive charging.
Make sure to put on the brakes as soon as we get into jump. Don't want to jump in this, go crazy. Believe this star kind of big. Gotta make sure we hit the brakes. That nice blue-white glow. Oh wow. Huh. How old is it? That's still pretty new. It has... It's like... Maybe all but these two have, atmospheres on them? I think everything's gonna be too hot, though. It's 1,000 light years. Or light seconds away. No, maybe. Just maybe some of this stuff.
Fuel scooping. Fuel scoop disengaged.
We'll get a terraformable out of this. Let's see. Class B, what was surface temperature? Oh, that's real. That's real toasty. But I guess it's not that hot for a B, but comparatively to what you normally expect to be, stars that are candidates for terraforming or having terraformable planets. Pretty hot. Maybe one of these is just far enough away that you get some terraformables. Yeah, I think. Yeah, we're good. We're good here. This is the binary too, so we'll probably make up on it. Yeah, it's still pretty hot. Oh, some of those are pretty far out there. That might be the correct distance for these. Yeah, see both of these. Both of these are pretty toasty. That's really dense atmosphere. So, I hold out is for maybe those two. Probably, yeah, these are on the other side of the sun. Or, yeah. So even so far away, it's really bright, and you can kind of see that all that blue huge tint, that blue-green reflection in the cockpit glass. Why'd that take us? Huh. I think I might hit my Excel button, but just be a goof. Yeah, that's still way too hot. I wonder why that one's so comparatively cold. Just the atmosphere is better, or maybe if they're tightly locking, that one's in the shadow of the other. Something like that. And we were paying attention to the map too much. See if there's anything going on with that one. One looks that one closer. Yeah, I guess it's closer. Yeah, it looks like we're kind of pulling away from this one. Crap. Okay, maybe a little bit of an overreaction there. See what this one's like. Thinking they're all just gonna be a little too rough to be terraformable. That one's terraformable. Huh. That's still really hot. I'm not sure. I mean, like, it's the atmospheric pressure is really high and temperature is really high. Carbon dioxide. That looks pretty fun. Not overestimating apparently how long it takes to get to all these places. I think I wasn't aimed directly at it. I guess that's one thing that kind of helps too if you're out here exploring the just space and kind of getting, you know, looking at maps and getting distracted by stuff is always aim just a little bit off center. And, that way, if you do get distracted and miss something, you don't careen into a planet and explode or anything. As long as you're in that general, inside that general circle, maybe just a couple degrees off, you'll, worst case, you fly past the planet. So both of those are terraformable. That is interesting. I mean, this one is a lot more reasonable, I think. Temperature wise, it's only 12 and a half atmosphere pressure. So I would think that one's a lot closer to what you would pick. This guy is just a little too toasty for what I would call a optimal terraforming, but hey, you know, game thinks it's terraformable. I'm not gonna complain too much. I will take the added value of the terraformable planet. I guess size probably is a factor in whether the game thinks it's terraformable or not. I'd imagine anything bigger than like 4 or 5 Earth masses would be kind of out the window. So this sweet spot is like 0.5 to 5. So we'll see. I'll be so. Okay. I thought the surface temperature played a bigger role, but maybe the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is just enough that, you know, if you rebalance it, it's terraformable. But I mean, this one's actually, you know, 1.19, relatively close to Earth mass. So, we're, let's see. We're 1500 from a soul, so, I mean, it's definitely not that far out. Picking up new stuff. What is that? Oh, T. Browndorf? Okay. It's weird that there's so many white dwarfs inside inhabited space. You have to go like into the core more, I think, to see white dwarfs, but yeah, that was, I don't know, roughly 2 hours. We traveled our 900 plus light years, picked up a couple interesting planets worth of data. I picked up the one Earth like. Up 7, 10 terraformables, a couple gas giants with life, water worlds, some of them already explored, but for the most part I think it's a pretty successful run. So with that, go ahead and call it a night. If anyone's still hanging around, you can hit the follow and I'll probably do more of this. Probably like 7 p.m. Eastern, somewhere in that ballpark. I have to do some exterior work at the on the house, but outside of that, I'll probably be doing some elite exploring after sunset and all that. So 7 to 10 Eastern. That I think we'll just head out to call it a night.